thank you for joining us again. It's just as important to give emphasis on the emotional well-being of women, how our mind functions, because it has a bearing on our physical health. God designed this human body in such a way that our mind is healthy, our spirit is healthy, our will is healthy, because if they are not healthy, that's when we actually experience body aches and autoimmune diseases. In fact, there are research that links self-hatred to development of autoimmune disease, like multiple sclerosis, diabetes type 1, eczema, asthma, and all that stuff. So if this is true, which research and neuroscience backs up, then it's truly important that we accept ourselves as we are. A lot of people are struggling with comparison and lack of confidence. And being as women, you know, I believe that it's our desire. It's at the core of our being. It's our desire to please the Lord, and we cannot escape. If we truly want to be a Proverbs 31 woman, you know, a woman that honors the Lord and loves Him, we can never escape Proverbs 31, chapter 31 in Proverbs. And you know, when I read this, and I will be honest, you know, how it says that she is talented, she is productive, she is hardworking, she is strong, she is courageous, she is kind, she is fearless. I mean, who can find her? When I read Proverbs 31, I can't help but cringe, like, oh my gosh, who can even find this woman, and does she even exist? So instill more of what you call this guilt on my part rather than being inspired by her. I've never seen a woman who is a morning person and a night person at the same time as this woman, and it describes that she has a lot of talent. Like, she's an entrepreneur, she designs her own clothes, she travels a lot, she provides food for her family, and I'm like, I can even not function 50% of what she does. But I think that's not what God's intention is, to provoke or instill comparison or guilt among us women. I feel like the Lord does not demand of us any gifting or talent that He hasn't given us in the first place, because there are women or people in general that are not physically capable of doing what the Proverbs 31 is doing, right? Romans 12 verse 3, it says that, this is Paul saying that, he was saying that, do not think of yourself more highly than you ought. That's what it says. But think of yourself with sober judgment according to the grace that God has given you. So God's remedy for us being prideful and boastful or a jerk or arrogant is that, you know, all our giftings are a gift in the first place. We are not the originators of our smart or our skills. It's all from the Lord. The same with salvation. You know, you cannot boast about your faith, because the faith that you have right now is also a gift from the Lord. And you're being saved, like, hey, I'm a daughter of the Lord now. It's not even, you know, because you're so good or you didn't sin, that's something that you earn. God is saying that, you know, you are saved by grace through faith alone. So we can never boast of our skills. We can never boast of anything, because everything is a gift. So if you are a woman, a lady, a girl, a teenager that's struggling with comparison, know that the Lord only expects of you to really excel on the measure of talent and grace that He has given you. So you can live in freedom, you know, you can live in boldness, that, you know, I don't have to compare myself with anyone else. And so back to Proverbs 31. I'm saying this, but don't worry, I'm gonna discuss still the inflammatory bowel disease. I'm just empowering you as a woman that you are special, that once you walk in the confidence that the Lord loves you, that you have your identity in Christ, then your health will also follow. Your physical health also follows from that confidence in the Lord. So back to the Proverbs 31 woman. If you read the context of the chapter, the New World Translation puts every verb in a present tense. Meaning to say that if you read it, it looks like the summary of everything that she did or she's doing is happening at the same time. But one commentary, a Bible scholar, actually researched, and the original script of Proverbs 31, all the verbs were in the past tense. Meaning to say that this is the summary of everything that she did in her productive years. It's not like she's 80 and she's still designing her clothes, or she's 90 and she's still strong. But the only inspirational verb there that is in a present tense is in verse 30. It says that charm is fleeting and beauty is deceptive. Beauty is vain, but a woman who fears the Lord is to be greatly praised. So it summarizes that the driving force of everything that she's doing, the way she honors her husband, it says that her husband trusts her. Why? Because she does him good all the time, not just when she's in a good mood. Even if maybe she thinks the husband is wrong, but she still honors him. And I love it when it says that her children call her blessed. It's amazing when your children sees that you fear the Lord. And also it says that she is clothed with strength and dignity, and she laughs at the future. Think of a woman that is not scared of anything. She doesn't worry. She's not self-absorbed. She's not afraid about what people is gonna think about her. She's you know, there's few mention about her physical appearance. It's more about how she is as a woman, being hardworking and productive. It says that she doesn't waste time. If she has free time, then she does something that's productive to her family and loved ones and to the Lord. But again, the driving force is, why is she doing this? Is she trying to impress anybody, or does she instill, literally, intentionally instill jealousy or comparison among women? Is she competitive? Like, no. It says that because she fears the Lord, and at the core of her being, she want to live her life in a way that honors God and honors her family. Also, if you read the chapters, it says that she's not only strong physically, it says that her arms are strong. I don't know if she goes to the gym, but in their economy, maybe she does, like, she's just active. She does a lot of stuff. But this woman is concerned about her physical strength. And she's not also scared about the weather. She said that, you know, during winter or the storm, she doesn't really, it's just afraid of anything. And I feel like the Lord is saying that if we as women have that driving force of doing this stuff, not to please anybody else, but to please our Creator, because we fear Him and He expects of us to really do our execute the gift that He has given us with excellence, then Proverbs 31 is not hard to attain. It's actually a gift. It is, the Lord will not put Proverbs 31 in the Bible, because it says that every word of God is God-breathed. It is effective for teaching, for reproof, for rebuke, and all that. So I feel like the Lord has put Proverbs 31 because He is saying that every woman, every human being is capable of becoming her because of the empowerment of the Holy Spirit and because we fear the Lord.